ComfyUI is a terrific way to interact with Stable Diffusion models, especially those that are a little bit more to the intermediate to advanced users. In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to install ComfyUI on a Mac so you can go ahead and start playing with this unique application. Let's go ahead and dive in. So first up, you're just going to want to go ahead and go to the ComfyUI GitHub repository. I went ahead and we'll leave a link in the description here. You're going to scroll down about halfway or so until you get to the Apple Mac Silicon section here. And we're just going to be following these four steps in order to get started. So first up, we're going to go ahead and install PyTorch nightly. So you'll just go ahead and click on this link, and this will take you to the Apple Dev Docs. And then we're going to go ahead and install it for Apple Silicon because that's what my machine is here. So I'm going to open up a new terminal window and then just paste in this command and it will download Anaconda 3. And while that's downloading, I'm going to go ahead and copy this next line so we can go ahead and get it installed. So I'm going to go ahead and paste that again. And then we'll be presented with the license agreement, which is pretty lengthy. And once we are done scrolling here, we're going to get to a dialogue here, whether or not we will accept the terms. So I'm going to go ahead and click type in yes. And then you'll be asked where you will want to install Anaconda 3 on your machine. So we're going to go ahead and just press enter to confirm the default directory here. Okay, and as it goes through the installation, you'll be probably presented with this dialogue if you want to automatically initialize Conda. So you can create an environment or just use the base environment. So I'm going to go ahead and let it go with the base environment here and just go ahead and type in yes. All right, so now that is done being installed. So if I close terminal and open a new one, we can see that the base environment is now set for this terminal window. So now we were going to go ahead and install PyTorch nightly as that's required for ComfyUI. So I'm going to go ahead and use Anaconda for that. So I'm going to go ahead and copy this and then go ahead and let it go through the processes here. And go ahead and type yes. And again, depending on your internet connection, this might take anywhere between a few minutes or more to download all the necessary packages. All right, so that is now all installed. So lastly, we can verify that everything is good for our system as it should output this. And in Visual Studio Code here, or you can use any sort of simple text editor, I went ahead and copied in all this code, Python code here. And then we're gonna go ahead and run it within our terminal. So let me just double check. I need to go to downloads. All right, and then we can see our torch test Python file. So I'm just gonna type in Python torch test, and it should have the same output that is in the Apple developer docs, which we can see here. So we know that everything is good to go for the next step. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and it says to follow ComfyUI for the installation here up in the window section. So you can download it, or I believe you can, but basically what we're gonna do is I like to clone the repository so that way I can go ahead and do the updates. So I'm gonna scroll up here and just click to copy the URL to the clipboard here. So I'm gonna go ahead and navigate to a tutorial directory that I have on my Mac here. And so I already have Stable Diffusion Web UI. This is the automatic 1111 repository. So I'm just gonna go ahead and put in git clone and then paste. And it will only take a few seconds, but now we have ComfyUI onto our Mac computer. All right, so let me go ahead and scroll back here to the instructions. And to install the dependencies, we're going to go ahead and go right here and install all the requirements. So I'm going to navigate in my terminal window to ComfyUI and then just copy and paste that pip install -r requirements text file. So that will take, again, just a little bit to download all the necessary packages to get ComfyUI to work onto your machine. All right, so now that that's done, we can go ahead and launch ComfyUI now. So I'm gonna go ahead and just copy this command and paste it while I'm in the ComfyUI tutorial directory. And it looks like that we have to put in this force floating point 6 flag in order to get things going. So unlike automatic 11.11, if that's what you're accustomed to, it does not open up a window automatically. So you're gonna wanna go ahead and just copy this URL and then paste it into the address bar here. And here we go. So we have the ComfyUI with already a preset prompt. So I was actually working on this a little bit to the video, and I know if I try to run it right now, it's not going to run because I don't have a model into the directory yet with ComfyUI. So whenever working with Stable Diffusion, you always have to download a model, and there's lots of places you can download these, like Hugging Face or Civitai. So basically, I'm gonna go ahead and go to the ComfyUI directory, go to models, and then here's the checkpoints directory. So this would be similar if you wanna just copy over all your models from, say, Automatic 11.11's web UI. You would go to the Stable Diffusion directory and then copy all the models and basically move them here. So I already have the Juggernaut Reborn Safe Tensors file that I downloaded earlier. And so now that I'm going to have that in ComfyUI. So I'm gonna go ahead and just click close and then click refresh. Or I don't even believe I have to do that. I can just go ahead and cue the prompt and then it will go through all the steps here in order to generate an image. So we'll go ahead and let it go through. And if you look at terminal in the background, you can see what the iterations are per second. You know, given that it is a Mac, it is a little bit slower. Although I believe the performance is a little bit quicker than Automatic 11.11's web UI here. But yeah, so now we have our first generated image. Awesome. And just like other interfaces, you should be able to find the outputs folder here. So if you want to go ahead and save the image or adapt on it, you can as well too. Now, one of the things with ComfyUI that's going to be worth talking about in a later video perhaps is understanding basically what all these nodes are and how they are used to generate an image. So again, if you're familiar a little bit with diffusion models, you can see this is basically our positive prompt, which is just a text box and it's connected to positive, the negative prompt here, the dimensions of the image, seed values. So you're gonna see a lot of the same terms just presented a little bit differently. And again, it would be worth discussing this a little bit more in a other video, but you can also install all sorts of additional nodes such like ControlNet and so on within ComfyUI, so you can really start to create some beautiful outputs here through this interface. And let's go ahead and jump back to that. And I think that is all for the instructions. As we can see, we got an output. So if you guys have any questions at all, please drop a line in the comment section below. I'll be more than happy to help you out there. And if you enjoyed the video or found it helpful, please consider hitting the thumbs up and also subscribing. Thanks so much for watching and have a good day. Take care.